Shut off the gas! Shut off electricity!
San Francisco, October 1989, rocked by a powerful earthquake. Neighborhoods like the Marina District were devastated when the earth shifted and liquefied beneath them.
The ground moves, and it moves, sometimes 5, 10, 20 feet, and essentially can just pull a building apart.
Some fear the same could happen here along San Diego's downtown waterfront if developers are allowed to build the high-rise Navy Broadway complex. That's because there may be an active earthquake fault right here.
The recently discovered Coronado Fault rattled as recently as 500 years ago. Young as faults go, it runs under Coronado in San Diego Bay and comes ashore in San Diego near Seaport Village, just south of the proposed complex. It's an active earthquake fault.
You want to know where it is, you want to know what it's capable of, and you want to know how often, you know, that it's going to generate the earthquakes that are going to be a problem to your structure.
But it's not just the fault, it's also the fill. This map, created in 1859, shows the bay before it was dredged and widened. But more important to our investigation, it shows the areas where fill was used to eventually create San Diego's waterfront. Like in San Francisco's Marina District, that fill can cause trouble. This is the trouble, liquefaction. It turns the ground into quicksand, bursting foundations wide open. That's what happens in an earthquake. These faults are serious business. Here's the seismic investigation commissioned by developer Doug Manchester. Consultant Geocon says in their report on the proposed project that they did not find signs of faulting at the site, saying it is suitable for the proposed development.
We wonder, so we have a qualified geologist, Dr. Jeffrey Johnson, review the Geocon study. And his 10-page report to the 10 News I team raises serious concerns.
Dr. Johnson says the geology study done by Manchester did not analyze enough data. The Geocon study is problematic, he says. Geologist Michael Kennedy wrote about the fault in 2001. He agrees with our expert, Dr. Johnson. Kennedy mapped and named the Coronado Fault as part of a Caltrans safety study for the Coronado Bridge. With our expert, Dr. Johnson, telling us public safety makes it imperative that the exact location of these youthful faults be mapped onshore prior to any development.
This bayfront area here, that may be kind of an indicator of where the trace of the general trace of the Coronado Fault is there.
Dr. Jeff Babcock at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography is mapping the Coronado Fault underwater with 3D technology. Babcock has not plotted the fault on land yet, but is sure it runs north under the Navy project and probably where the Port Commission intends to build its new development as well, connecting near Old Town with the Rose Canyon Fault, which is also active.
I would be hard-pressed to say that you're going to get anything as big as, a magnitude 7 like you would on the Rose Canyon itself. But we don't know.
We took these concerns and our geology report to Manchester and to the Port Commission, since they're building as well, but no response. So we go to the mayor's office.
It's our understanding that Manchester Development has done an initial seismic study and that seismic study has shown that there's no active earthquake faults. The Navy appears satisfied with it because there have been Navy buildings on that property for close to 100 years.
The Navy may be reconsidering. They joined us at Scripps to learn more about this earthquake fault, and I gave the officer a copy of our geologist's review of the construction site. You can see it for yourself. Just go to 10news.com and click on Investigations. For the 10 News I team, I'm Marty Emerald, 10 News.